Hey everyone, so we're on to the second part of doing a hair. It's going really well. I'm really happy. I'm hoping everyone is working really well and is really happy as well. So as we left off last time, we just did the top of the hair, and I hope you've all done well with that. Please remember to put some comments below if you have any questions. I'm happy to answer them. So now we're going on to the sides of the hair. Now I did do one side. I did one side earlier. So as you guys can see, it's all done there. And I just wanted to show you, that looks a little bit thin there, but it's actually really not. It's funny how photos come up, isn't it? It's like, not from my angle. So anyway, when I wanted to show you how I was doing and how I went with it, to show you exactly what it's going to look like for you. So the other side will look the same, and then we will have just this back part here to do. Okay, so I'm going to put the camera down a little bit lower so you're not just focusing on me. Oh, I'm so crazy. Anyway, but you're focusing on the hair. So let's get into that a little bit. Let's bring the camera down here to baby's level. Okay, so as you can see, as you remember the hair I did before. Now, some people may have not done that hair, and that's okay if you haven't. But I do have to say that it did make a difference, and it did help with what I was doing. Okay, so why it made a difference is because, look how cute he is because I followed those lines. Just like I did when I was working on the crown part, I followed those lines. So as you can see, these ones sort of go around like this. This one sort of goes up like this, and this goes inwards. Now, when I did this side, you may see that I sort of worked back, like I didn't do all of the front part. But what I have done is, you may or may not be able to see, I've done some really, really fine ones there. So just particularly random. Now, I'm sorry if you can't see that very well. How dare me not be able to show you. But I think you guys can see there. You can see that I'm sort of grabbing some hairs. And they have just given it just that little bit of definition, which is kind of like combo hair. So it's brought it in from, how do I say this? It's painted, but we're putting a little bit of combination in there, which makes it seem like it's not as painted. So it's got a bit of realism in there, a bit of 3D with some very fine hairs, okay? So in that way, you don't have to go all the way to here, where normally I would be doing more over here. You can start a little bit back and just put some of those fine hairs in there. So what I'm going to do is just show you a little bit of how we do start that. I'm just going to get my little pillow. Okay, so this is just so you guys can see how I did it. I'm trying to prop you up a little bit more there. And I'm going to be working kind of backwards. So as I always say, please bear with me. So maybe I should. I'm going to get up and try to get in a good position so I can keep the head where it is. So I've got my hair like I did before. Now, as you guys know, I only keep about an inch that I'm working on. And I hold it there and root it into place. So, just if anyone was forgetting, I think I told you guys earlier, but I'm working with a 40 gauge one barb needle. It's one of my favorite needles that I like working with the best. So that's just what I'm working with. You don't have to work with that. So I normally just start down at the base here. Okay, so pushing in. Remember to keep your needle flat towards the head. Don't put it in like this, otherwise you'll have pokey outy hairs. I'll try to go back a little bit. Okay, so keeping the needle flush with the head to a certain degree. So then we just push away, and I normally start by working around the ear section, just like that. Hopefully that's giving you guys an idea. And I work around in the direction that my lines have been going. Okay, just like that. As you can see. It's so hard to see because of the painting that I've done, but you can see the hair there. Okay, so then I just keep on gathering layer upon layer, keeping my plugs or my entry points very close together. Because especially with my hair being going to be thicker, I need it to be closer together. And I like it to be all nice and uniform, as you've seen in earlier images. So that's what I'm doing. I think you get the picture. I'm just working with my line. Now, when I get up to this section, I'm going to work towards here and then just do my fine hairs in this area. So hopefully you guys can get that. I don't really want to sit here and make you watch every last moment, but I will video a little bit now for you to watch, okay? Okay, so as you can see, I've just given it a spray down. It's best to do that every now and again just to keep it all in check, to keep it all in area. Otherwise, you know, like as you can see, my fingers have slightly moved this so that it puffs up a little bit. So it just keeps it like in space. But as you can see, I've done some tiny hairs here. Now, I won't need to do many. It's just like giving it that 3D sort of look. And then I'm working my hair up to sort of this area here. So I'll even angle it sort of, actually I'll be angling it that way. So going in with it. So to go in with the flow of where that's going, as you can see where that's going. And then I'm just going to work up, up, up until I get to a triangle point about there. So you will see that much of the hair done. And then all we'll have to do is that back part. Okay. So I'm going to keep going with that and I'll show you again when I've done that part, but I think he's looking quite good. Okay, keep up the good work, guys. Chat. Okay, guys, so we are really moving ahead now at a great pace. I'm really happy with how everything is going. Here is my little boy, well, not my little boy, but Levi, as we are up to now. So you can see, once again, I can see that part looks really thin, but it's not. It's just on the hairline, so it's the hair split. There is completely plenty of hair in there. That all of the hair, every plug is very, like, millimeters apart, literally millimeters apart. So what you're seeing is a little bit different to what I'm seeing on the camera. But anyway, now we're going to go to the back of the head. So I'm just going to start off. I normally always do around the bottom as a moon. So just doing in the direction, I normally do about a centimeter. And then I work in a direction where I think I want the hair to go. So up here, I'll be working to meet up here in this direction. Actually, sorry, let me take that back. I'll do the bottom and then I'll work in this direction. So I'll go up and I'll be going in this direction. So around like that. So I can meet up with that crown in the same angle. So around, so it all meets. And then this side will come up. So all directional, okay? So I'm just going to start on the bottom so you can see. And then I'll sort of show you how I'm going along the way. I'm just bringing the camera back in here so you guys can see where I'm going or what I'm doing. I think yous all understand how I do this. And for those of you who might have watched other videos, this is pretty much exactly how I did the last video when I did the rooting on the preemie baby. So, once again, oh, look at my needle. See that? Can everyone see the angle of my needle there? So this needle has been pretty much going for the whole time, pretty much. I think I broke one really early on. But as you can see, the pressure I'm putting on the needle, not necessarily too much pressure, but over time it will weaken, it may bend, and this one is likely to snap soon. So don't be afraid if you have had some broken needles. It all goes part and parcel with being a reborn artist. So I'm just going to start in the nape of the neck here, and I'm just doing like a bottom hairline. That's why I'm going across the whole bottom. And that bottom hairline, it basically just gives me my hairline. There's nothing else to it. I'll work from that, like I said. So I'll do the hairline all the way across on both sides, and then I'll work on the angle that I want to work up. So I think you guys know what I mean. So I'm not going to take up too much length of time on the video, because I'd rather use just see me go as I'm going, pop in with some viewing up-to-date pictures. So I'll just let you guys watch me do this for a little bit, and then I'll pop back in with a where I'm up to stage part. Okay, so just showing you where I'm up to. As you can see, the hair going around towards the ear there, you can see how I've angled it to go around in the ear's direction. And then I've just gone along the bottom, around half a centimeter to a centimeter, all the way up to the other ear. So now, as I said before, I'm going to be working in the direction of an angle like this. Sorry, like that. But I will show you as I'm going how I'm going. And yes, if you've got any questions, please ask. We are definitely getting somewhere now. Okay, so as you can see, I'm moving up the back of the head there. It is directional. It's going in the direction I want it to go, as you can see. So slowly it's getting there to where I want to be. I've probably literally got another... anywhere between 2 to 4 hours to be realistic on that, and that will be sitting here working on it all afternoon. So okay, so I'm getting there slowly but surely, which is very exciting. So you can see I'm still trying to directional. I should get my finger and point in there. I'm trying to directional this part here. I went up and into this section, as you can see there, and I'll keep going up in there. And this will start coming around like that, like the edge of a teardrop or a water drop. So I still have a few hours to go, but we're getting there. I hope that you're understanding where I'm at, even though I'm not doing it like frame by frame. But I think you all know by now how to do each little plug rooted in there, and then... you know, once you know that, it's just a matter of following your heart, following your lines. And if you're feeling a little bit confused, like I said, just get your pencil, your Prisma pencil, and just draw the lines and then follow them. Just simply follow them. Okay, so I'll be back in a second again with where I'm up. Okay, I'm getting too late in the afternoon here, so the light is dying. So unless I want to set up my own light, this is how we're going to look at it here. You can see how I'm going there and how I'm directionally rooting it towards that crown there and meeting everything up in its point. So I'll keep going. There's still a few hours work to go, but it's a long, tedious job, but it needs to get done. Okay, guys, so you can see... I don't know if you just saw that last image. My camera died just before I was doing it, and I had to keep going. But this is where I'm up to. I'm finished. It is all done. Like I said, again, you know, like that looks really patchy to me, but looking at it like in real time, like you could probably see from back there, it's everything's covered, everything's swirling, everything is doing what it should do. So I think it's just the camera for some odd reason. Anyway, so I am finished the hair. Oh my God, yay. And I hope you are finished too, or hope you got everything from that. So we're just going to do the finished part of the hair now, and then that'll be the end of this video, and then we'll go to putting it together, trimming the hair, putting it together. So right now I need to do the eyelashes quickly. So I'm going to bring the camera closer. Come here, guys. Come here. Bring the camera closer. So I might even put it down here so you guys can see a little bit better. Now, just don't want that light to reflect on you guys. So the eyelashes are just so easy, guys. We've done them before on other videos. So it's just what you were using before, the same needle you were using, the same hair. And literally, you just go along the line of the eye. So I'm going to try to do this again in a weird angle so you guys can see it. Oops, I've just had a magnet stick to my needle. And you just do a line along here. Very fine line. So I'll do a couple to show you how we go. You can see, hopefully, that there's little hairs going in there. And we don't want them too thick. But if they are too thick, we can pluck them out at the end. So it's no big stress. So you can see that very fine there. So I'm going to go ahead and finish that now. All you have to do is go along the line. Won't be a moment. Okay, so there are his eyelashes all done. So as you can see, I just went along the line. If your eyes aren't that great, I would really suggest you to get a magnified LED light or something so you can really see, because I have seen people do the eyelashes like this before and they're so, so easy to do. But I've seen someone that might have gone above the line here and there and it just looks really, well, not tacky, but it obviously doesn't look realistic because it's not on the line. So don't stress too much if your eyes aren't good. You've just got to get all of the proper ingredients to make it all work for you, okay? So I'm not going to cut his eyelashes yet. There's no need to do any hair cutting. The best thing when you're working with hair is you don't want to fuss with it too much. So once you've done whatever you've done, comb it to a degree, but don't go over combing it because it will be pulling out little hairs here and there. So if there is any too many hairs, like if I've got too many hairs in the eyelashes, I'll just get my tweezers after and I'll just cut them out and make that finer. So don't stress with that too much. Now it's time to glue it all in place. And I'll put this down a little bit so you can see that a little bit better. What you need to do now is get your glue. Now I have talked before about what I use. I use the gel bond glue. Now I get this from Bunnings in Australia. I'm not sure if it's available anywhere else in the world, but it's by Parfex, so you could always look it up online. The reason I use this, it's because it's a gel bond. It is heat and water resistant. So I'm in Queensland in Australia, so it can get, the conditions can get pretty warm. So I thought if it ever got really warm, then the glue would be protected. It wouldn't really change consistency. Water resistant, obviously, we are spraying the baby's hair and combing it a lot, and I don't want any water sort of seeping in and then forming a mold or anything like that. So that was my base around that. And because it's a gel bond, I thought it might make it a little bit flexible as well. So that's my thoughts behind that. Now I've been using this now for many years and I haven't heard any bad reviews on it or anything in Reborning. So of course, you can use whatever you want. There's some people that use tacky glue. There's some people that use E6000. So just get, you know, talk to other Reborn artists and get an idea about what everyone wants. Now, I've just remembered that I have forgotten something, as I always do, so I'm just going to go and get that, and then I'll be back. Okay, so let's start. You will need to have, if you're using your pacifier dummy, you'll need to have that available at the moment, and the magnet, some paddle pop sticks or craft sticks, I'm not sure what you guys call them, and then I've got my hemostats and another sponge, which you'll see in a minute. So I'm just going to start first with my eyelashes. So for that, I'm just going to use my paddle pop stick, craft stick, and I'm just going to I'll just show you the glue. It's a yellow consistency. Don't mind all the anything in there. You can mix it a bit if you want, but it's all good. Just going to get a little bit here and then put it behind. Now, if you are doing this, sometimes it's better to work with a lot of light going inside your baby so you can see everything. But for instances of the video at the moment, there's enough light for me to know what I'm doing since I've done it 1,000 times. So I'm just going to get my glue and just put it behind the eye on the eyelashes there to secure my eyelashes in place. Now, if you've got, if your baby is open eye, I do have another video on, you know, inserting the eyes and all that kind of thing. So you might want to go back and look at that video. I'll try to remember to attach it here, but I can't promise that. Sometimes I don't, I'm sorry. But if you can't find it, you could always send me a message, put a message below and remind me. Okay, so that's what we do for that. Now, I can't really show you because it won't probably show up too well, but there is glue behind the eyelashes there. Okay, sweet as. So next we're going to, I'm not going to actually do the dummy yet, or shall I? No, I'm going to do the hair next. So when I'm doing the hair, I always like to just put my baby kind of like in a little vise. I've just got a little tape dispenser here, or a roll of tape, the big tape, and I just put him in place like that, and it always sits really well for me to use to spread the glue. Okay, so I've got my hemostats here. Don't laugh at me. Most of you already know what I do with my hemostats. In the beginning, I used to clear all the glue off, but then I got so busy that I just didn't anymore, and it still works, and I do sell them if I want a new one. So just get your hemostats, and then one of the sponges you've been working with, as you can see, I've been doing mottling with this sponge. I don't want to use a fresh sponge, so that's why I use one of these, and I just put it in the end of my hemostats and click it shut. All clicked shut. Now, nice and easy these are to use. I highly recommend them because they get deep into the kit, as you can see. So all you need to do is smudge some glue on there, and then make sure it's not going to drip anywhere, and then get it inside the kit just like that, and just run it around. We need to coat all of our hair sections, so use as much glue as you like. As you can see, I've used a big pile there. And just be careful putting it in. You don't want to get it on the hair on the outside or anything. So just really, really coat the inside. Don't be shy. And don't be shy, like I said, to use more. Now, as in drying of this, you'll need about 24 to 48 hours. It'll probably dry much, much quicker. But I'm not in the habit of rushing things. I want to make sure it's all totally set and in place before I continue with anything. So, of course, look around. Make sure that there's any spots you've missed. Get them. It's very important. And just keep swishing it around. Okay. So looking at that, and it's all done really nicely. So that's fine. So if you don't have a pacifier or anything, you know, all you do now is just leave it like that. But of course I have a pacifier, so I'm going to put him face down. Actually, first I will get like this. I'm going to put a little bit, a little dab of this glue behind his mouth. Just like that. Just so when I put my magnet in, it's already got a surface that it's going to suck into, and then I'll put glue around it. So I don't know, as everyone knows, I've got my test passy. I've been using this for so many years now. It's got a bit of glue on, it's got a bit of cracking. I recommend that, and why I always recommend that, sorry that I keep on going low here, why I always recommend that is because now every baby I sell, I use the same passy. So if someone comes to me and said, Anair, I really want another passy for my baby that you made me, I automatically know what way it is facing. It is a brilliant idea. Please get yourself a test passy. So just put it basically in place of where it's going to be. Hold it there with your hand, with your both sides of your hands like this, and then throw into the game your magnet. So that'll throw in and it'll stick to where it should be. Okay? Now, personally, as you can see with this passy, I don't like it. I don't think it sits really nicely on him. So he will definitely be having a different one when the time comes. He's not going to have this one, but I mean a different sort of shape. I don't like that shape on him. So once you've got your passy in the exact position you'd like it to go, gently put him down. You don't want that to move around. Then get your craft stick with glue and even if it's a lot, and put that in behind the magnet. Now this, so it's got glue, the magnet has glue underneath it, and now it has glue surrounding it, which is definitely going to keep it in place. There's nothing worse than your customer after a couple of months saying, oh, the passy is not sitting on the mouth anymore, and that's because it wasn't secured properly in the first place. Like I've said before, don't be afraid to use a heap of glue. You know, it's only glue. It's only going to probably cost you 20 cents more or something like that. Okay, now all you do is make sure that the passy is in the exact position you want it, and you'll just sit it on the tape dispenser, or you can use a mug, a cup or something, and now put it away where no one can knock it. Put it up on a high shelf, away from the children, away from the grandchildren, away from yourself, away from your elbows. Put it away. And now leave it there for 24 to 48 hours, okay? And then we're going to come back and we're going to put Levi together and we're going to put your baby together. So thanks for watching. This is all going really well. We've finished. Now we're on the final home path. Woo! Okay, guys, love you all. Chat in a minute. Before I go, I thought I should let everyone know what to do with this. Of course, you just release the sponge from its position and put the sponge into the bin, and then you're left with your glue hemostats. So of course, if you know you've got a fairly new set of hemostats, you know, just wipe it off. You can use your odorless thinners, but it might be a bit expensive, so get yourself a cheap bottle of methylated spirits or turpentine or something like that. Get all the glue off. If you're going to be like me and be a bit lazy, you need to rest this on like concrete, just on the ground, and leave it open. If you leave it open, it won't glue. Okay, awesome. Hope you got that, and we'll see you next time. Bye, guys.